Good afternoon. Welcome to the Soccer Down Here SDH Network's Game of the Week. It is from McIntosh Stadium, Peachtree City, Georgia. It is Lambert. It is the McIntosh Chiefs going at it. And it is John Nelson here. It is Jessica Charman over there. Jess, the conditions a little wet. They have been the last couple of days, but we've got turf.
Yeah, absolutely, John. Not many high school games would have been played in these conditions, I'll tell you that. But here in Peachtree City, they are blessed with a fantastic turf pitch. We've spoken to both coaches. They're excited about these conditions. Both teams have practiced on turf. They've practiced this week in the rain. So this is going to be a really good, quick-paced game.
And you look at these sides, and we also, in catching up with McIntosh, we also found out that because of all of the activity that happens here on the McIntosh campus, they have to go to Peachtree City MOBA to get some reps.
Yeah, actually, Peachtree City MOBA in the USL have some great turf facilities just down the road. So they've been playing, like we mentioned, in these conditions. They're used to the turf. But so are Lambert. Against other teams, it might have been an advantage. But here, I would say it's fairly evenly matched against a really strong 7A side in Lambert and a really competitive state champions of 2019, 5A, the McIntosh Chiefs.
All right, so what are we looking at for formation-wise for both sides?
Well, when we spoke to both coaches, we've got a 4-3-3 for Lambert. They're going to play a triangle, an inverted triangle in the middle. They're going to sit defensively. That, to me, signals that they feel threatened by the formation of the 4-4-1-1 that McIntosh are going to be playing. They expect to change things up a little bit, McIntosh. They haven't been perfectly happy with how things are going, and they want to play one up top and try and move the ball through the big center forward.
And the beauty of conditions like this, and I'm going to go ahead and break the fourth wall already. My glasses have started to fog up.
I'm glad I got my contact lenses in today, John.
As we look at things here in the first 40 minutes, McIntosh will be going from left to right as you picture things in your mind's eye. Lambert will be going from right to left. And to take us through the first 40 minutes, here's Jessica.
Good early possession by McIntosh there in the green, searching for the long ball over the top. That's Galbraith on that one, but cleared out of bounds nicely by Hennessy.
Good work there defensively for Lambert to cut the angle off and knock it out to slow down that first rush 20 seconds in.
But it'll be a throw in deep in Lambert territory here. Stepping up to take it is Lauren Snell, the senior. Just a little pause in play right now. It was actually given against McIntosh there. It'll be a throw in favor of Lambert. McIntosh attempting to pin in and do very well there to regain possession. And this time it will be a throw-in for Snell. Over the top, good touchdown by Miner. 50-50 challenge there. And that one always going in favor of the defender, John.
1 minute in, heading back the other way. It'll be Lambert's first chance. Scott Luthart, 1-0 out of the blocks here in 2020. Last year, 22-1, 10-0 in region, nationally ranked number 4, number 2 in the state, as they had a tremendous season.
Handball there called by Zenis. Lambert looking to play that one quickly over the top by defended well. Great step by Van Zyl there, looking to get the 1-2 pass. In these conditions, hard to get that first touch, and that one a little bit too heavy there by Miner.
Last touch by Lambert. It's going to go McIntosh's way.
Long ball over the top, searching for the run of Galbraith, but instead it's Lambert that may regain possession. Strong tackle there out of the blocks, though. Yacom looks to spread it wide, but Van Zyl won't keep that one in play. It will be a goal kick for Lambert.
Once again, you're seeing McIntosh out of the block, sitting there and pressuring Lambert to try to get a quick turnover and another opportunity offensively, but couldn't quite handle it there. The 1-2 was a little too much, and it's going to be a goal kick for the Longhorns.
It'll be a defender here taking the goal kick. Schulte, Maddie Schulte, a commit to Emory, starting in goal for Lambert, opting to not take her goal kicks today. Big boot by Captain Hennessy, headed down nicely, though, by Zenis for McIntosh. 50-50 ball eventually given in favor of Lambert. A throw in down the line here. Good control with her back to goal by Clark and wins another throw in for Lambert.
Quick reminder of the rules. Two 40-minute halves. We will have halftime. we'll kind of work our way through this particular game. This was set up the way it was. Initially, it was going to be two matches, but we have a quick run here by Lambert having to regroup all the way back in their own net. McIntosh again sprinting very quickly down their side.
But it's Lambert that are coming away with it now after that long ball over the top. Haugen unable to get that one under control, though, and McIntosh again down the right-hand side. A good step defensively, though, for Lambert. Go all the way back to Zenis, who opts to play it back to her goalkeeper here, Ali Seibert. Great pass into the midfield, and even better touch by Macy Simon with her back to goal. Spreading to the left-hand side this time. McIntosh looking to attack, but this time good defensive play by Lambert.
McIntosh, just a really young team when we had the conversations before the match today.
Yeah, and it's showing a little bit out there. You can tell they're a bit too eager to get the passing going. Sometimes you need to hold on to the ball instead of rushing things out there. I think they're looking. This is one of their first collegiate games. Potentially, they're trying to make a statement early on. But this time, they do get a good switch, and Van Ziel attempts to get that one across to her teammate, and it will be Joachim. Long ball over the top, headed out by Lambert. Attempting to keep it in was Fontana, but instead it'll be a McIntosh throw-in.
4.5 minutes in here at McIntosh Stadium. Thanks for hanging out with us. You can reach out to us on Twitter, at SoccerDownHere. She's at Just Talks Footy. I'm at OSG Nelson. You can reach out to us in any of the ways to hang out with us here this afternoon as we are watching McIntosh and Lambert here for the Soccer Down Here Game of the Week. It was great to be in Gwinnett County last week, catching up with the folks at North Gwinnett for the Norcross North Gwinnett doubleheader. Next week we'll be in Cobb County for Pope and Harrison. It'll be good to see the Hoyas in action going up against the Greyhounds.
But McIntosh now in possession here, comfortable with building it out around the back, not rushing things now, but a poor pass there will allow Haugen a chance to counter. Haugen, center of the pitch, opportunity to shoot, and a great save there in net by Ali Silber. That one skipped up in front of her, too big paws to push that one out for a corner.
Haugen wound up with the right. Two paws on it just to kick it wide, so it's going to be a corner kick as you're envisioning here the action for McIntosh Stadium. It'll be a corner from the near corner flag, and it will be a chance for Sydney Hennessy to take the corner for Lambert.
Lambert lining up all on the edge of the goal line right now, making things very difficult for the McIntosh defense. Looks like a set play they've worked on the training ground as they check out to the PK spot. That one, though, not going to challenge anyone as it hits the side netting of the goalkeeper's net.
Near side for that. And we are coming up on minute number 7 here at McIntosh. Goalless between Lambert and the Chiefs. Lambert 1-0 on the season. A week ago had the chance to start their season off against Pace Academy with a 3-1 win. It's going to be a quick turn for Lambert as they get to host Brookwood in 2 days' time.
Zenis with a good goal kick there, but a sloppy pass again by McIntosh will equal a throw-in for Lambert. Selke with the throw-in over the top, finds Clark on the spin, who spreads it wide with a beautiful pass searching for Zimmerman. That one speeding across the turf, but Zimmerman able to keep it in. Fantastic defense, though, on that far left side. And a great delivery into the checking Galbraith as she lays it through, but a good recovery defensive play there by Lambert to clean things up.
Had to go backward a little bit to go forward, and you almost lost the sprint when you had one Lambert player and one McIntosh player retreating into the middle third for the Lambert half, but Lambert out with it now.
Good distribution there by Fontana to spread it wide to Haugen. Captain Haugen now entering the 18-yard box. A beautiful ball across the box, and that one scuffed up in the air. I think it was a shot, but instead dropped favorably. And that's a push in the back. No. And McIntosh get a little bit lucky there, John. It looked like Haugen was fouled in the box. Two hands in the back, but referee shakes his head.
And Scott Luthart from Lambert wanted the whistle there, as did the players. Didn't get it. Lambert back at it again, but McIntosh will get out of trouble.
Long ball over the top. A good spin there by the McIntosh forward, Galbraith, causing all sorts of trouble in that holding top position. But it will be a throw-in for Lambert.
Heading toward the 10th minute here. Gullis at McIntosh.
In fact, it'll be a throw-in for McIntosh here. It's Lauren Snell, the senior, with the throw-in. Chipped over the top by Olivia Miner, searching for the run of Van Zyl. Van Zyl unable to keep that one in there. The turf out here, John, moving very fast.
Selke was there to defend for Lambert. And good work there to kind of shepherd and shoulder off to make sure that it stayed a goal kick for the Longhorns.
Sydney Hennessy, the captain and UT commit, taking this goal kick. Maddie Schulte, as we mentioned, not taking her goal kicks today, opting for the long ball from her captain. And that's exactly what it is, down center towards the halfway line. It was Clark with the touchback, but defended well by McIntosh. An even better delivery there, searching for the run of Galbraith. Galbraith on the edge of the 18, trying to cut inside, whips in across. It's blocked well. Stumble by the Lambert defender, but eventually able to clear that one out of danger. Turned over immediately as Lambert looked to turn defense into offense, springing the run there of Haugen. Haugen with a nice dummy move to beat the defender. She's into the 18-yard box. Good block again by the McIntosh defensive line. McIntosh looking to break forward, though. Van Zyl with the ball into Galbraith. Returns it to Simon. Good passing move there to find Miner. Miner into the feet of her forward. Gets the ball back. Again, McIntosh comfortable with laying it back to their defense.
Good work that time by Sydney Hennessy with the entry pass coming from center circle by McIntosh. Headed clear, it will be a throw for the Chiefs as we come up on minute 11.
Lauren Snell again with the throw in. This time the ball to the wing blocked by Lambert. It will be another throw in, though, as McIntosh looked to build on this possession.
Kind of taking it a third at a time right now, McIntosh, with this second throw here in this particular possession. Looking Snell for something inside the 18.
Great throw in there by Snell. The movement off the ball by Galbraith really created an opening there. But it will be offside there against Van Zyl. Linesman signaling that she came back from an offside position to challenge that one.
All right, so since we've hit the quarter pole here in the first half, what have you seen, even though the conditions and the rain is picking up here at McIntosh Stadium?
It's absolutely end-to-end stuff here, John. The ball is moving fast, but both teams looking for a long ball over the top. It's a battle of quick defenders against quick forwards, but all it's going to take is a slip from one defender, and there will be an opening.
McIntosh with it center circle, having to play it all the way back, and it's going to go all the way back to the keeper because of an errant pass. They're going to have to rebuild off their idea of rebuilding out of the back, but errant pass again, and it's going to end up being a Lambert throw as Madison Haugen looks like she's going to grab the ball on the track. Initially, she was going to take the throw, but then she'll hand off. It's going to end up being Asia Selke.
Selke with the throw looking for the return pass, but another sloppy pass. And, John, I think we're going to see plenty of this today with these conditions.
I was going to ask you, what's it like to, since you've done this before, I have not. I have not played in wet conditions. So what's it like to play on a day like this out there?
I mean, it's a nightmare in terms of your first touch. It can be fun because you never know what's going to happen. You have that level of unpredictability that can work in your favor with the ball over the top. But when it comes to first touches, when it comes to reading the pass, getting those quick passes in, it's really difficult for a team like McIntosh, like Lambert, who like to play quick tippy-tappy football, to play the way that they want to play.
And you can see there with the throw with Asia Selke, the ball slipped out of her hand on the follow-through, but Lambert ends up with it middle third over on the far side. We've got a foul call.
Just a little overzealous there in the midfield by McIntosh. Looked shoulder to shoulder, but referee stamping down on that one. Good that he's offering his authority early on, because in these conditions, when you're slipping, when you're sliding, it can get dangerous if you go in too overzealous. Long ball over the top. goalkeeper there, very confident with the one-handed take out the air by Ali Silbert, using all of her 5'9" there to reach that one.
And you made a point before the match started to find out. You said she's tall, and then you actually found out that she is 5'9" and had great command with the ball there, just one-handing it, making sure that it's stuck in the glove.
I'll tell you, I wouldn't have tried that one in these conditions, but all fair play to Silbert because that was fantastic composure there. Long ball over the top, cleaned up by Lambert, and that one last off of McIntosh's Lauren Snell. It will be a throw in here, 35 yards or so away from goal for Lambert. Trotting up to take that is Asia Selka. Selka looking to thread it over the top to Clark. Clark with some great body strength there, finds Selka on the wing. Selka took a little bit long there, allowed the recovery, but spins out of the challenge, spreads it across to the midfield, but another good
interception.
Great step by McIntosh there. Now looking to turn it into offense with a nice turn by Galbraith, but that ball, no one up top there because Galbraith had opted to check back. Dangerous ball over the top will trickle into the hands of Silbert, though. Great positioning by the goalkeeper.
Once again, just laying it long and seeing what would happen and, you know, getting a chance to run underneath it. Lambert, but it ended up hitting up in Silver's mitts first.
Cracking slide tackle by McIntosh there. It is Galbraith now laying it all the way back to her captain, Zenis. Zenis with a little space there. Looking to switch the ball towards the midfield. Does well. Good first touch by Miner. Miner now with a chance to stretch her legs. Plays it into the center. But another strong defensive play by Lambert Tennessee there.
Here in minute 15, McIntosh had a chance right in front of the net about 14 yards out. But then you see Hennessy just clamping down on that offensive attack right there in the middle of things.
Lambert looking to build things out of the back there. Fontana laying it wide to Hong. Hong's pass read well by the McIntosh midfielder, though. Scrappy 50-50 ball, though. It's controlled nicely by Joachim. Joachim tries to step over that one. Mistouched it a little bit, but Van Ziel will spin. Got plenty of space, Van Ziel. It is knocked long, though, by Lambert, and it's Clark again with her back to goal, but the 1-2 pass isn't going to work there. All the way back to Silbert in net for McIntosh, spreads it wide to her left back, Kimmel. And Kimmel's pass chased down, and we will see our first substitution.
Endless running by Lambert's Emerson Zimmerman, trying to be the force up front for Lambert here.
We see Taylor Donaldson checking in for McIntosh. It is a lot of effort out there. You mentioned endless running, and in these conditions, it's even more draining. Long throw over the top for McIntosh. Good first control, but the pass a little wayward there allowed Lambert a chance to break, and an even more wayward pass out of bounds for the throw-in halfway in the McIntosh half. Lambert now with a chance to build.
Let's see what happens here. I mean, we've seen Lambert try to go over the top and have a lot of different players like Haugen run underneath it. Big right boot through the hands and in the back of the net. Taylor Clark launches it, and it goes through the mitts of the McIntosh keeper. It's 1-0 Lambert.
Look, if you don't shoot, you don't score. And in these conditions, you want to be taking shots, John. You talked about changing the dynamic, and that's what Lambert did there. Clark took control outside the 18-yard box, took a shot, and in these conditions, Ali Silbert won't want to see that one again. A little above her head, just slipped through. But these conditions for a goalkeeper, I'm always going to be team goalkeeper. They are difficult. We praised her earlier for her confidence, but you've got to be careful in these conditions. It's better sometimes to parry than to try and catch.
So Lambert with the first goal on the board. Big vote of confidence for them early on in these conditions. Remember, we talked about the quick turn that they're going to have to take going up against Brookwood in 2 days' time, and it's going to be 3 matches in 11 days for Lambert, with this being the front end of that run.
Fontana, looking to switch the play, does well with the ball over the top, but McIntosh cleaning things up. They need to respond positively to this. It can be difficult to go behind under circumstances like a goalkeeping error, but they're a championship team, and they will know that they need to respond differently to this. And that's a great challenge to start things up by the substitute, Donaldson. Looking for the overlapping run of Van Zyl. Goalkeeper out to smother that one, Schulte.
Once again, Asia Selke getting back on defense there to make sure that the ball ended up in her keeper's hands first as McIntosh was working their way in the offensive third.
Schulte with the long flat punt, easily returned by Miner. Miner with a second opportunity, chips it in to Galbraith. Galbraith trying to turn and split the defenders with the pass, but it is Lambert that come back to recover it. Again, another turnover. Ping pong ball here between the two sides, but McIntosh do come away with it, and it is Miner. Miner looked like she was going to have an opportunity to shoot there, opted to pass, and instead it falls favorably for Schulte in goal.
Was trying to get the 1-2 working with Galbraith and Miner there, but it almost looked like it was deflected, took a big pop up into the air, couldn't get the 1-2 figured out. And Lambert had the chance, and they're going to have it again here. And looks like, what's the call? Another keeper. Going to say another keeper mistake, but what happened here?
Well, Schulte got very lucky, John. That's what happened there. It looked like she was trying to play around with the ball. Maybe it was out of her area. She was trying to get it back into play.
Right on the edge, yeah.
Miner pressed her well, but referee deemed that the goalkeeper had the ball in her possession with the tackle. I think Schulte might have got a little lucky there.
Coming up on the halfway point of the first half, we've had conversation dealing with both keepers so far, but the margin is still 1-0 to Lambert, and they'll settle things down inside their own six.
But it is interesting to me, John, how the goalkeeper is already opting to slow down the play and potentially quote-unquote time waste. There's still 20 minutes left in this first half, plenty of game to play. For me, get the ball in your hands. Look to break fast. You never can sit on a 1-0 lead. Lambert now with possession. Clark threads it through with a great pass there. Second pass not so good, though. Miner wins that one with a good challenge. Look to spread it wide across to O'Neill.
Caitlin Olsson there for Lambert to try to make sure that they could keep possession in the middle third. It was a throw now for the Longhorns, and they'll have it center circle, but conditions and the ball hopping over. A lot of sets of boots, and it ends up in the center circle. McIntosh with a break.
Galbraith with some great work there. She's getting her mileage in today, checking back. But unfortunately for her, when she gets there, she doesn't have any options because she was meant to be the most forward player as a foul is called against McIntosh. Lambert with a dangerous area to whip a delivery in here. About 36, 35 yards out. It will be Hennessy stepping up from her centre-back position to whip this one in with the right foot, right on the touchline here. Lambert opting to line up on the edge of the 18 towards the right-hand side. Ball is chipped in towards the penalty spot, headed away nicely, and Van Zyl back to clean things up for McIntosh. Quick 1-2 pass there with Galbraith. And now it is Donaldson. Donaldson switching the play, looking for the run of Annie O'Neill, but cleared comfortably out of play there, defended smartly by Lambert.
Olsson gets there first for the Longhorns. We have another substitution for McIntosh coming in. Avery Mitchell will be coming in at the next opportunity as she's got the practice vest off. Throw for Lambert here.
Throw in up, but headed well by Annie O'Neill into the midfield. Donaldson tries to flick it on. Good work there, as you say, John. But that pass, just a little wayward, ends up falling favorably low. Spread wide. Here's Clark. Clark on the edge of the 18-yard box, drills it across the 18, and that one, unfortunate, the own goal. Clark with some fantastic work down the left-hand side, drilled a dangerous ball along the ground, bobbled up, and the defender there had no real option but to turn that one into the back of her net.
So Emerson Zimmerman was a part of that in front of the net. So you'll call it an own goal here at 21:56. And now it's 2-0 for Lambert. Once again, Lambert taking charge of their opportunities. Taylor Clark with the centering pass goes in to a couple of different sets of bodies. We thought that Zimmerman might have touched it last, but own goal. And so it's now 2-0.
And, John, we talked about McIntosh needing to respond positively, and right now they need to step up their dynamic. It's been really tough up top for Galbraith, who's been putting in a lot of the legwork. She's been checking back. But, unfortunately, when your center forward checks back to the halfway line, there's no one in front of her for options to go to goal.
I was going to say whistle called on Lambert there, so it'll be a free kick. Close to center circle for McIntosh.
And another free kick there called against McIntosh. Lambert with an opportunity just inside their own half to launch the ball forwards. Direct has worked for them so far. And it's looking like they'll try the same again. Tennessee over this one. Tennessee with the big boot towards the 18-yard box, headed down well, though, by McIntosh. Minor attempts a swing clearance, and it's blocked by the hand of a Lambert forward.
And before we go any further, I want to give a shout-out to the McIntosh and the Lambert fans who have made the trip, and they are hardcore sticking it out because the rain has picked up. And you got a lot of umbrellas here, but you know, you give both sets of fans who are here today a lot of credit for hanging out in these conditions.
Absolute troopers. We're happy to be undercover in the press box.
That is correct. We have expensive equipment that must be protected at all costs.
Like my hair.
There you go.
McIntosh looking to respond positively here. Nice by Van Ziel. A good triangle. Finds Snell. Snell was playing into the feet of Galbraith, but the defender stepped nicely. She'll get a second opportunity to challenge things, but smartly done by Selke. And she looks to release a sprinting Haugen. Haugen putting on pressure to the goalkeeper as the ball was passed back. And it will find McIntosh on the right-hand side. A step by Fontana. Knocks it out of play for a McIntosh throw-in just short of the halfway line.
Looks like we're going to have two more substitutions checking in for McIntosh. Number 15, Marina Serra from the midfield. She's checking in, as well as Emily Item, number 21. So one of the midfielders, one of the defenders now checking in for the Chiefs.
McIntosh just looking to switch things up. I doubt the coach will be happy with how things have transpired so far. They'll be hoping to make an impact from the bench here as Hennessy knocks it all the way back to Schulte in goal. Schulte with the under-hit pass there. McIntosh with a chance in front of goal. Galbraith shoots, and Schulte grateful that that one went straight into her hands.
When she was trying to clear it initially, looked like she got behind it and got more of the turf than she did the ball, and it really wasn't a whole lot of velocity behind it. Ended up in McIntosh hands for their chance, and it ended up right on, but nicely done for two hands on the ball for the save there for Lambert.
We talk about tough conditions, and we're going to keep reiterating it here, but goalkeepers need to be smart. They need to make good choices. Sometimes you don't need to play it smartly around the back. You just need to go long. As McIntosh win that battle on the halfway line, they'll try and break down their left-hand side. They will earn a throw-in just across the halfway line. Throw-in is taken fast. Galbraith tries to head that one up to herself, does manage to spin and release Donaldson. Donaldson had one to beat, but smart defending there. And Lambert knocked that one long and over the top. Zenis trying to release Snell, but it is turned over, and now Lambert will look to break. Good spin by Clark. but unable to get a good pass on as the ball goes all the way back to Silbert in the McIntosh goal. Silbert's chipped ball finds a Lambert player. But some good defensive work there by McIntosh. We'll see Galbraith in possession. Chipped over the top, looking for Idem. Idem in a foot race, but it is knocked comfortably back to Schulte, who clears.
Another rush for McIntosh here. Not giving up a lot of pressure now here in the last minute and a half to 2 minutes for the Chiefs as they're trying to knock down this two-goal deficit.
Good step there by Snell, but it just bobbled in front of her, unable to get a shot off as she crossed the edge of the 18-yard box. That one, no difficulty for Maddie Schulte in goal. Schulte with a jumping punt towards halfway. It is Lambert in possession as they look to spread it wide. A touch off of a McIntosh player will mean it's a good throw in here in a deep area for Lambert.
Laney Cassidy checking in now for Lambert. Good work by Asia Selka. We mentioned Asia Selka and saw her play a lot here in the first 27-28 minutes for Lambert. Nicely done for the Longhorns.
And the Longhorns with a long throw and over the top to Clark. Clark trying to cut it back in a similar way till she did to the second ball. McIntosh deal with this one more smartly. A high foot called against McIntosh here. So it will be another opportunity for Lambert to deliver a ball into the box. 35 yards out here. Hennessy stepping up to take this one. It is on the right-hand side. She's right-footed, so looks like it will go towards the back post. That's where all her teammates are lining up. Chips it in towards the penalty spot. Goalkeeper out there. And that one skipped into the hands of Ali Silbert, and she'll feel good about that.
Outlet looked like it slipped out of her hands, but stuck with McIntosh, however, briefly. Big boot to clear into center circle. McIntosh has another opportunity here.
Galbraith lays it across. Good, quick pass. First touch by Idem. Not quite there. Invited the defensive play by Lambert as we see another substitution.
Anna Duval, number 18, in for McIntosh, and she will give Lauren Snell a bit of a breather.
Duval will take the throw in. Long over the top, looking for the searching run of Galbraith. She earns a throw-in with her pressure. McIntosh stepping up the field here, 25 yards from goal on the right-hand side with this throw-in. Duval again, looking to find Galbraith. Galbraith unable to get that one under control. And the goalkeeper there, Schulte, will let that one trickle out for a goal kick.
Substitutions coming in for Lambert. Looks like it's going to be Lindsay Webb, number 15, coming in, and Chloe Pendleton, number 19, coming in. Taylor Clark will get a bit of a breather, as will Caitlin Castelli. So two in and two out for Scott Lutart and the Longhorns.
Long goal kick towards the halfway line. Beats everybody there as it trickles towards the goalkeeper. She wanted it to be played back to her feet, but instead Silbert realized it wasn't going to reach her. Her pass goes straight to Lambert's Fontana, and Fontana with some strength to get it wide to Haugen. Haugen cutting into the 18-yard box. Good strength by Haugen. Final tackle is cracking, though, by the defender there for McIntosh. And now they'll look to play out of trouble here. Heavy first touch, though, invites Lambert to defend, but falls favorably to Galbraith. Galbraith with a good shimmy step there, looking for the pass over the top, but well read by Schulte in goal to come out to collect.
Let me go back to what happened at the other end that created this last McIntosh possession. You had Haugen working her way here in the near corner, which she's been able to do here in the first 40 minutes. And you saw a one-on-one situation, great physicality lined up by Anna Duval, but then you had a little help, and then it turned into a one-on-two, and that created the chance for McIntosh to quell that run for Lambert to bring it the other way.
Yeah, McIntosh are doing great with their recovery lines. They're putting bodies behind the ball and helping to create those defensive overloads that allow you to pressure strong players. And they do, again, have an overload, which allows the ball to go out for a throw-in for three substitutions. It's Catherine Kimmel, Macy Simon, and Caroline Kimmel, two twins heading onto the pitch today for McIntosh.
Yep. That's pretty much the only way that you can tell them apart is by the number on the back of the jersey. It's good to get some stories from Casey Kreitner, the head coach, before we got the chance to kick it off here today.
Good work in the air to find Simon. Looked like it was going to break for McIntosh, but instead well defended by Cassidy. Goalkeeper pops it up. McIntosh try and win it in the air. They're unable to do so. Ball stays in play. No, it doesn't. Linesman pointing in favor of McIntosh for a throw-in halfway in Lambert's half.
Ball was sent back by Laney Cassidy, and you know, Maddie Schulte had to try to kick it with a lot of velocity as it was coming back to her, and she kind of chunked the first one, popped it up into the air. Then the second chance, she had a better opportunity to get rid of it.
Great work by Idem in the corner. Dangerous delivery. Turns and spins as Galbraith, and that one will trickle out for a corner. But that was fantastic work by Emily Idem, the substitute there in the corner. She didn't give up on that ball, was able to deliver a dangerous cross. And that was one of the best opportunities that McIntosh have had in this first half.
Megan Hong there to defend for Lambert. Put a leg up in the air, deflected off of her to create this opportunity under 7.5 to go first half.
In swinging corner kick delivery towards the penalty shot. Galbraith is there with the header, tried to head it down, but that one always going wide.
Off the back of her head, the angle wasn't quite there, ends up going wide here to the near side, so it'll be yet another goal kick. And Maddie Schulte will surrender the duties. Looks like it's going to be Sydney Hennessy who will bring it forward.
And Hennessy's deliveries from that goal kick have been great so far. She's got a big boot on her, good strength. And as we mentioned, in these conditions, you don't want to mess around. She perfectly finds the head of Lindsay Webb, who flicks it on. Cleared up by McIntosh. Checking back all the way is Idem. Idem loses possession, though, does win a throw-in for her team.
Working quickly, McIntosh.
Galbraith came back to win that one. Looked to spin and play the ball over the top. No one home. Clearance deflects off of McIntosh. I'm surprised that one goes in favor of the Chiefs, but it will be a McIntosh throw-in.
A lot of bodies back for Lambert. 5 and 6 back to try to defend McIntosh here on this run.
Galbraith again trying to check back and spin. No help in front of her, though. And Lambert now with a great touch. Zimmerman with a great move there.
Nicely done to defend.
Fantastic work, though, by Emerson Zimmerman. That outside foot touch to break away down the line. Fantastic move. Cassidy takes the throw in fast for Lambert. Returns to her. Messes up her touch, though. And it will be McIntosh in possession with Simon. Simon trying to play the ball through. Two Lambert players get in each other's way, though. And it is McIntosh in possession. Long ball through, searching down the left-hand flank. Defended smartly, though, by Lambert there, shielding the ball. Very strong play by the Lambert defender there over by the corner flag.
Caitlin Olison doing great work for about a 15-yard stretch, trying to make sure that McIntosh couldn't get anything done with it over on the far side, headed toward the far corner. She shepherds it out, ends up being yet another goal kick for Lambert, heading up toward 5 minutes to go here, first half, up 2-0.
Big kick forward towards the halfway line. McIntosh learning to sit back a little bit and welcome that one on. They do get possession back. Olison there showing her strength again as she turns to defend. Shields that one out of play and knocks it smartly off of the attacker to earn a throw-in for Lambert.
So now we're officially under 5 minutes to go. When you have substitutions, the clock will stop temporarily now that we're under 5 minutes.
Lambert with the throw-in headed out again for McIntosh. They're just tiptoeing up the pitch right now with this series of throw-ins. Lambert will be in no rush. 2-0 up. They've been very happy with their first half performance. McIntosh will be disappointed. They wanted to make a strong schedule for themselves. We talked to the coaches. This was a game they were looking forward to. And right now, they've just been an inch off the pace, John.
You schedule the likes of St. Pius and Woodward and a lot of the private schools that are heavy-duty teams when it comes into the postseason. You want to be challenged by that. And we'll get into it at halftime as well, that there are times that you can learn things even when you come up with big victories.
tight foot skills there by Castelli, but defended smartly by Zenis. Zenis with a great ball over the top. Foot race for Galbraith. Galbraith unable to beat Schulte, though. Her starting position has been fantastic to come onto those long balls over the top. Turned over, though, and McIntosh again. Galbraith searching for the runner on the left-hand side. But again, Schulte is there getting her steps in.
Coming up on 3:15 to go here, first half at 2-0. Schulte foot into football, puts it out just shy of center circle. A couple of different sets of jerseys getting possession of it. Looks like it's going to stick with Lambert trying to work it forward.
Kept in nicely by Lambert, right on the touchline was Haugen. They keep possession in the midfield just over the center circle. Some good work defensively by McIntosh to double team, but that one will be a foul. Lambert will have a free kick just inside the McIntosh half as clock ticks to 2 minutes 40 remaining in the first.
And you see Lambert here with that 2.5 and counting, kind of taking their time, setting things up, making sure that they can get to the intermission with this two-goal advantage.
Long ball over the top, headed nicely away, but this time back into the danger zone by McIntosh. They get a second opportunity to clear, and it will find Galbraith checking back. Galbraith trying to lay off the ball across. She does find Idem. Idem spins and plays it central. Right-hand side, but it's an even better defensive recovery there by Lambert.
Good flick.
McIntosh working hard, making the game a little scrappy right now. They need to be physical against this Lambert side. Lambert able to get possession, though, on the halfway line as Pong checks in. Here's Haugen on the spin. Haugen with a little chance to stretch her leg. Has three green jerseys around her. No foul. Checks back in, but who's there? Of course, it is her captain, Sydney Hennessy. Lambert now in possession out the back. McIntosh doing better to press. Galbraith ever present there, but it does fall favorably for Lambert.
4 and 5 bodies back consistently for Lambert to get things started on these possessions.
Cassidy pressured and earns a foul there. The push called against Idem. Idem did well, though. We call these a professional foul on the halfway line. A smart professional move there.
Make sure that you sit there and slow things down. If you think that pace is a little too quick for you to get your defense set up, you make sure that that whistle gets blown, taking care of business as we're under a minute.
Hennessy on the halfway line, far left flank, whips it in towards the midfield. Cleared first time up in the air by McIntosh. It's a white jersey that comes out with it for Lambert, though. Lays it all the way back to Hennessy. Hennessy with a second opportunity. This one falls favorably, but McIntosh with a strong challenge there. Ticky-tocky play there by McIntosh, but they put themselves under pressure. They do win a throw-in, though, as the clock begins to tick under 12 seconds.
Looks like they're going to take their time as we head toward halftime here.
Throw-in over the halfway line. It will be given as another Lambert throw-in, but that will be it. Your score at the half here on Soccer Down Here, Lambert Girls Soccer 2, McIntosh 0.
All right, we had a goal at 16:34 with Taylor Clark getting the first goal of the match for Lambert, and it was the one that went through the keeper's mitts and into the back of the net.
But let's focus on the strike from Clark. We don't want to dwell on the goalkeeping errors. It is tough conditions out there for Ali Silber. I feel for her. She would have wanted to save it. But Taylor Clark has been a workhorse out there for Lambert. She's been chasing down lost causes. She's been using her body strong. And she took a shot when she saw it. She saw the opening. She saw the opportunity. She drilled the shot. It shouldn't have been a goal, though. For Lambert, McIntosh will feel disappointed that they went down a goal in that sort of way.
Then the second one, you called it an OG at the 21:56 mark that made it 2-0. Once again, you had Madison Haugen, who was really doing well here on the near side, working down her left channel, sends it in outside the six, and it was three bodies that were there, and it ends up being an own goal that made it 2-0.
Yeah, it was a fantastic work by Haugen on that left-hand side. When you do that work, when you put in a low drill delivery, you give yourself the opportunity to create a goal no matter how it happens. The delivery was dangerous. It was bobbling. And for me, from my angle, it looked like the defender turned it in, but she had no other option. If she didn't put it in, the forward was going to put it in. So there, it's the quality of the delivery from Haugen that creates the goal.
Once again, thanks to our sponsors here for the Soccer Down Here Game of the Week, Jason Wright and the Jason Wright Agency. Go to Jason Wright, A-G-E-N, on Twitter, or go to the Jason Wright Agency Facebook page to get advice on all your insurance matters when it comes to Jason Wright, the Jason Wright Agency, and our friends at Country Financial. Also, Apolinsky & Associates, LLC, trial lawyers with over 30 years of experience. You can download the law firm's app for free, and you can get all the answers that you would like at aa-legal.com. They have online live chats, wrongful death, and personal injury trial lawyers with over 30 years of experience, $37 million in verdicts and settlements in the state of Georgia and Alabama. Georgia Trend Magazine recognizes them as legal elite for being one of the top 100 trial attorneys in the state of Georgia, featured in Newsweek, Time, and other magazines as well. When you look at the schedule here for the Soccer Down Here Game of the Week, last week we were in Gwinnett County for the Norcross North Gwinnett doubleheader. We're here today in the Southern Crescent for McIntosh and Lambert non-region play, and we'll get into that in just a little bit with Jess and the toughness of non-region schedules and how you want to challenge yourselves. And we caught up with McIntosh to get those ideas. But next week, Pope and Harrison. It will be on the 21st. We will be on the campus of Harrison High School. So the Greyhounds and the Hoyas, that doubleheader next week, Pope and Harrison for the Soccer Down Here SDH Network Game of the Week. Looking forward to it. And so, of course, mercifully here at the half, Jess, is when the rain is its hardest that it has been to date.
Yeah, I think the girls are going to be happy right now that they're off the pitch.
They're inside the covered benches and everything's great. So it can rain hard for about another 6 minutes, and then it can dial itself back a little bit as we get ready for the second 40. But you know, one of the topics that I wanted to get into you with was challenging yourself in non-region schedules and challenging yourself and what you can learn in different aspects of things. And you can learn a lot about yourself. You know, Lambert knocking off Pace Academy, winning 3-1 last week. And for McIntosh, it was a 12-0 win, but in catching up with head coach Casey Kreitner, she said that you can learn just as much in a game like that as you can in a close one coming out of the blocks.
Yeah, definitely. When we spoke with Casey, she mentioned that one of the things she learned in that 12-0 victory was that they needed to finish their chances in tough games, and she'll be disappointed with how the girls have responded to that win. Sometimes it can be tough when you go from playing what is an uncompetitive game into an extremely competitive game because you don't have that rhythm. But today they needed to finish the opportunities that they've created. I only remember one or two decent opportunities for the Chiefs so far, and they haven't finished them in front of net. So Casey's going to be telling them at halftime, hey, we're not going to get the opportunity to score 12 goals in this match. We need to finish the few opportunities that this extremely stout and physical defensive line of Lambert are going to give up in the remaining 40 minutes.
And we saw McIntosh in a 4-4-1-1, basically. And that's so for those who are listening who are still learning formations and the elements of the game, when you're looking at a 4-4-1-1, break that down. What does that mean?
So you're going to have four defenders that are going to sit back. You're going to have the four midfielders that are going to try and work in that midfield, pushing forward, pushing back. Then you're going to have one attacker that's looking to check back in to create that link between the midfield and the forward. And then you should have one player that's staying forward as a target player. But right now, the formation isn't working for me. Caitlin Galbraith had set up as that last number one, the top player, but instead during this match, she's had to check back continuously to the halfway line and even into her own half to receive the ball. And the issue with that is that when she does regain possession, when she does turn and spin, there is no one in front of her, and she cannot, no matter what quality of a player she is, she cannot turn and run the remaining 50 yards to goal and get a shot on. She needs numbers ahead of her.
Then on the flip side for Lambert, I want to say it was a 4-3-3 that they were presenting in the first half. And we saw a lot of work down the left-hand side with Haugen. We saw Emerson Zimmerman getting in through the middle and over on the far side as we were looking at things. So the 4-3-3 seemed to be working in the first half for Lambert.
Yeah, I agree completely. I think that Lambert has set up more successfully for this game. Not only have they got wingers that are putting in a lot of work, their wingers are being disciplined, they're pushing forward, but they're remembering to check back. But it's that upside down triangle with the two holding mids that's really helping Lambert when it comes to defending. We talked about having overloads, talking about having bodies back, and it looks like every time that McIntosh get into the Lambert half, there's six bodies behind because they're getting their wingers back. They're getting all three in that triangle to return defensively. And what they're doing well right now is transitioning from defense to offense.
All right, so what else? If you were in both of these covered benches, if you were say Casey Kreitner, you were say Scott Luthar, what are you telling these groups as we get ready for the second 40 minutes?
Firstly, to shoot. As we've seen the rain continue to pummel down, the conditions are getting even worse. Neither team is taking many shots from distance, and I think they need to. When you make a strike in these conditions, you never know how you might connect with the ball. It might slip, it might spin in a different way that makes things very different for the goalkeepers. And I would be telling my forwards to follow up on everything, whether it be a long ball over the top, whether it be a shot. Keep following in, because all it takes is a slip, a stumble, a misread on the ball, and you're in and through at goal.
And as we look at the flag, Old Glory from behind us is almost straight up and out. It is a couple of flaps that are going through, but the wind definitely did pick up. This was not a straight down rain. This was some rain that had some wind behind it, and it's coming from behind us and onto the field, so it's creating a bit of a crosswind. It could, if this does stay up, could create some havoc in the second half.
Yeah, it's really tough conditions there. I can't emphasize enough how difficult this makes the game, not only for goalkeepers, but for players too. I'm imagining we're going to see a lot of missed touches, some slide tackles here, and I see you looking at the goalkeeper warming up there out for McIntosh.
You know, Allie Silbert.
Oh, it is Allie. Yep, I was wondering if they were going to make a change, but no, it's Allie Silbert out there, and I feel like if you're the coach, you're reminding her, hey, get your head in the game. There's a reason why we have you in this starting position. We trust you. You're a great goalkeeper. Let's get some catches under your belt in these conditions in the last 1 minute and make you feel confident when the ball does eventually come to you.
And especially in these conditions, you saw, you know, we were looking down here on the side toward the bench, and the coaches were making a point to see how Allie was handling the ball in this rain. And, you know, challenging her height-wise a little bit, having some stuff over the top of her head, seeing how she would respond and react to those kinds of things. And so it'll be interesting with both of these keepers how things were, because Maddie Schulte was having her issues as well. Hers were more ground-based and trying to clear the ball when it was sent back to her as they were trying to build out of the back. And she did defer on her goal kick, so we did see that as well. But once again, the keepers, I think that'll be a focus here in the next 40 minutes.
Definitely, and I would like to see McIntosh press a little bit higher. I think they've been slightly reserved. They haven't been pressing the goalkeeper as much as I would like to see in these conditions. And when you're trailing 2-0, you haven't got much to lose here.
Once again, reminder, thanks to our sponsors here for the Soccer Down Here SDH Network Game of the Week, the Jason Wright Agency, and our friends at Country Financial. Go to the Jason Wright Agency on Facebook. Go to Jason Wright with a W-A-G-E-N on Twitter to get all the information from the Jason Wright Agency when it comes to all of your insurance needs with our friends at Country Financial. Also from Apolinsky and Associates, LLC, trial lawyers, wrongful death and personal injury trial lawyers. Go to aa-legal.com. Over 30 years of experience, knowledgeable, compassionate, successful trial lawyers. Stephen Apolinsky, the firm's founder, experienced Atlanta trial lawyer, recognized as legal elite by Georgia Trend magazine as one of the top firms in the state of Georgia. You can also download the Apolinsky and Associates app. Download the law firm's app for free and get all the information that you need from Apolinsky and Associates. Serving clients in Georgia and Alabama, they have garnered over $37 million in verdicts and settlements. Time to get you ready for the second 40 minutes with the score. Visiting Lambert Longhorns 2, it's the McIntosh Chiefs nil, the homestanding Chiefs here at McIntosh Stadium. And to start you for the final 40 minutes of the Soccer Down Here SDH Network's Game of the Week, Jessica Charman.
And it will be Lambert in the white jerseys now, kicking from left to right. McIntosh got on that pitch a little bit quicker. It looked like they were raring to go. McIntosh in the green jerseys, kicking from right to left. And for me, McIntosh probably just want to get that first half out from under their minds. They don't want to think about how they played.
Want to see how it ends up here once again with positions flipped. Lambert will be going from left to right as you picture the stadium in your mind's eye. And they are in their white jerseys. McIntosh in their home green with the black shorts. They're going from right to left.
Lambert pick up the early throw in here. Starting the way they started the first half. Looking for that direct ball over the top. Foot race there, but that one will trickle out over the end line for a goal kick. Ali Silbert still in net, as we mentioned.
Once again, just reach out to us on Facebook and Twitter. And she's at Jess Talks Footy. I'm at OSG Nelson. This is also at Soccer Down Here. So if you're listening to us, if you're hanging out with us, and might be drier than us, let us know what's going on right now as you're listening to the Game of the Week.
Goal kick skips and takes a couple of bounces. McIntosh attempting to press that one, but knocked up in the air. Finds Fontana. Fontana with a nice dummy there and lays it to the wide flank. But some good pressure over on that right-hand side by Zenis to force the throw-in for Lambert. Lambert with the throw-in just shy of the halfway line, but again, defended well by McIntosh. McIntosh at another gear here as Olivia Minor looks to lay it wide to the far side of the pitch. Some good recovery defending, though, and fantastic step over there by Sydney Hennessy to release that one over the top. It is blocked by McIntosh, and it will be a throw-in for Lambert. They attempt the 1-2 from the throw-in. They under-hit it. McIntosh pressure well, but it falls again favorably to Maddie Schulte in goal. Schulte's punt is up and high. Takes a bounce or two on its way to Clark, but a good read in the air by McIntosh. We hear the referee from here urge the girls to keep playing as the long ball is looking for Galbraith. Hennessy tries to deal with that one, but Galbraith is there. She shoots, and that was a good effort by Galbraith there, always sailing wide off the far post. But we mentioned, John, take your opportunities.
Sydney Hennessy had control, but then you see Galbraith come along and take the ball away from her, kind of leaned back as she was going for her follow-through, ends up going wide as you're looking at it, headed toward the far post from the near side, and it was wide the entire way. But a great opportunity 2.5 minutes in.
Hennessy knocks that one long. It's flicked on, searching for the run of Clark. Instead, cleaned up by McIntosh. A good little juke spin finds Galbraith again. Galbraith spreads it across to Simon. Simon looking to switch it one more pass on, but a great recovery there by Haugen all the way back in her own half to defend.
Backtracking, Madison Haugen. We're seeing her all over the place, and here defensively off of this possession, a little more than 3 minutes in, preserving the 2-0 lead and the charge by McIntosh that go-around.
Minor on that right-hand side tries to drill a pass across. A foul is called against Lambert. It will be a free kick for the Chiefs here. Just in front of the corner flag, it will almost be like a corner delivery here for McIntosh. Just a couple of yards back towards the halfway line, though.
Looks like the foul was called on Asia Selka there. Two-person wall set up. And let's see what McIntosh has in mind.
Setting up all their players on the edge of the 18-yard here, just in front of the far post of goal. Out swinging delivery towards the penalty spot. Free header, but it's just over the top of the run. Will they get a second opportunity? They do, but it's not a clean cross there. And instead, Lambert with possession, knocking it long over the top. Chasing down is Zimmerman, but confident defense there by Pickard to lay that all the way back to her goalkeeper. Simon checks in, lays it back to Pickard. Pickard over the top in to Galbraith. good triangle plays there by the McIntosh Chiefs as they look to spring Kimmel. Kimmel does well with her back to goal to earn McIntosh a throw in deep in the Lambert half.
Nicely done on the overlap that time by Catherine Kimmel to get down the near sideline. She'll have the throw for McIntosh.
Throws it over into the 18-yard box. First touch there by Galbraith allows her to spin, but a strong tackle on the edge of the box for Lambert. Looked like they got caught in two minds there, Fontana and Hennessy, but it is eventually Hennessy that knocks it wide. McIntosh, though, with the hard work to recover. Lambert eventually coming away with it, laying it all the way back to Hennessy. Hennessy rolls over the ball, lays it to her fullback. Confident move there by Lambert as they play themselves out of trouble here. Beautiful soccer, and the long ball over the top is misread, and Zimmerman now with a chance and a fantastic slide tackle. Beautiful slide tackle there by Zen is perfectly timed as Zimmerman looked to run into the 18 yards.
Great idea from Caitlin Castelli, and back comes Lambert off the quick turnover.
Clark's cross is blocked there, but that was a great break by Lambert. And John, we mentioned at halftime, the transition from defense to offense by Lambert today has been second to none.
Castelli found Zimmerman, and Zimmerman, the only thing that kept her from going in for a great opportunity for goal number three was a hard tackle defensively. Sound work by McIntosh there to keep it at 2-0.
Lambert here in possession. Heavy touch, though, and a strong challenge by Galbraith allows the green jerseys to come away with it of the Chiefs. Nice through ball there, but it looks like Hennessy will recover it. She does, lays it back to her goalkeeper, who one time passes that one away. Gets a little bit lucky there, fell favorably for Lambert. Wasn't the most convincing of clearances. And Hennessy again with a chance to control things as she lays a simple pass to Fontana. Stepping in is Huffman. Huffman spreads the play wide. Again, it's Haugen. We mentioned her name a lot in the first half. Haugen and Clark looking to interchange things there with the 1-2, but too much sauce on that one, and it will be a McIntosh throw-in in their own half.
You saw the work by Madison Haugen there, and she tried to dip her right shoulder so she could sit there and work it with her left boot as she's going down the far sideline from left to right. Coming up on 8 minutes in, and McIntosh has had their opportunities. Lambert has as well, and so right now we're still stuck at 2-0.
Will be a McIntosh throw-in, though. They've definitely come out stronger in this second half. Whatever their coach told them at halftime seems to be working so far. A nice little spin, but again, the ever-present defense of Lambert with the strong challenge. McIntosh throwing on the halfway line. Far side here as the rain continues to fall into the body of McIntosh there. Long ball over the top. Galbraith's first touch a little heavy, but she does get onto it. Bounces for her. Strong challenge, but Lambert will come away with it again. Good challenge by McIntosh. Haugen breaks through a challenge, though, and releases the Lambert player in front of her on this far side. The dummy is read fantastically, though, by the McIntosh defender.
Taylor Clark once again combining with Haugen and Aja Selka over there on the left-hand channel for Lambert. They have really had a lot of quality work among the three of them today.
Throw in for Lauren Snell on the far side. McIntosh just edging up the pitch. Good first touch by Miner. She looked to turn and spin. Strong play by McIntosh. They're pressing a little bit higher now. They do win possession. Annie O'Neill. Nice wide ball there, searching for Galbraith. Galbraith whips it back, but that cross not really in a dangerous area there. It trickled too far backwards and allowed Lambert a chance to clear things.
Castelli had possession, but once again, McIntosh upping up the pressure volume, getting the ball away from her middle third.
High press is definitely working, but this time it's Lambert that high presses with the crunching tackle. Clark unable to release the forward in front of her, though, and McIntosh will take a sigh of relief and look to regroup through minor. Pickard. Pickard taking a couple of strides forward here over the halfway line. Was trying to release Galbraith, but instead it's blocked by the Lambert defense, and it will be a throw-in just in front of the halfway line for McIntosh. Galbraith with a nice turn and spin, but behind her is Megan Hong with a strong challenge.
Caitlin Castelli along those same lines with Hong. Gets the ball back to the middle third, but McIntosh back with possession. But two on two, very, very quickly, Lambert trying to get out of a jam in their own defensive third, but it looks like they will with the throw here after it hits a couple of different bodies and goes out.
Lambert just having so much organization in defense right now, putting bodies behind the ball and making it very difficult for McIntosh as it's misread there by Kimmel. Fortunately, the ball had enough pace on it to find her goalkeeper, Ali Silbert.
Looking for Madison Haugen again. Haugen thought that she was out of reach with it. Then it snuck through the two middle defenders, tried to track it down, but it ends up in Maddie Schulte's hands.
Unable to control that pass was Galbraith. Instead, falls for Hennessy. Lambert caught themselves in a bit of trouble there with the triangle pass, and instead Miner steps on. She hits the brick wall of Hennessy, though, and Lambert now trying to play out of trouble. Good spin by Hong there, and over the top long ball to the right-hand side, looking for Haugen, who switched sides on the pitch. Goal kick is short and straight to Hong there, and it's long and over the top.
Coming up on halfway through minute number 12 here, second half, still 2-0. Goal in the 17th minute, a goal in the 22nd minute have been the difference in the first half. 2-0 as we went to intermission. That's where we've been right now. And it's brought back in. Silbert decides not to take it this time and lets one of the position players do it. But middle third, it ends up in Lambert's possession once again. Good cutback there to keep possession was Sydney Hennessy over to the far side.
Hennessy's been absolutely incredible back there. A lot of composure, and her tough challenges are allowing Lambert the opportunity to break forward every time as the referee calls a throw-in. We will see a substitution, it looks like, in front of us.
Anna Duval at the next opportunity for McIntosh. Looks like this will be that next opportunity. So Duval is in, and Catherine Kimmel will exit temporarily.
Throw-in deep in McIntosh's half right here. Lambert pressing high. Four bodies fairly close to the thrower here. They won't want to put their players under pressure with this throw-in, McIntosh. It's long and over the top looking for Miner, but it's headed right back into the danger zone by Lambert. Clark tries to turn and spin, is blocked, but again falls to a white jersey, and Lambert now trying to build forward here. Good spin and looking for the run of Haugen. As we mentioned, Haugen switched from the left side to the right side, and she's causing all sorts of trouble no matter who she attacks.
Exactly. Pick a side, and Haugen is going to be there pursuing the ball, and it really looks like McIntosh has been having problems tracking Haugen down and trying to figure out how to make sure that she's not the offensive force that she has been today.
Miner opts to play it out the back there. And that's turned over cheaply by McIntosh. Clark lays it back to Haugen. Haugen with the shot. And a good save there by Ali Silbert. That one hopped right in front of her. A great drilled shot down to Silbert's left. But she was there and equal to that one, John.
Madison Haugen sets up that big left foot. But Silbert was there to block it. Kind of an in-between hop. Did very, very well. Chested clear, couldn't get her hands on it, but chested clear, and it's going to be corner kick here on the near side in the right-hand corner as you're visualizing what's going on here at McIntosh Stadium. Hennessy with the look. Let's see what happens. Back post. And a foul call, so it's going to be a goal kick.
Disappointing delivery there. The outswinging delivery never challenging anything as it hit the crossbar and went out of bounds by Lambert. They'll be disappointed. They're not getting as many opportunities right now. They need to take them when they come as Miner flicks that one on for McIntosh. It is Sydney Hennessy there with a no-nonsense clearance, and that's very smart defending by the captain.
Substitutions coming in for McIntosh. Taylor Donaldson coming in, the junior, and Emily Idem coming in, the sophomore.
And I really liked Idem when we saw her in the first half, John. She's a workhorse, and that's exactly what McIntosh needs right now. They need people that are willing to press, they're willing to put in the legwork, and put under pressure the Lambert defenders.
Macy Simon will be taking a seat temporarily for the Chiefs.
Minor whips that one across, defended well, but it's still in the 18-yard box. A slide tackle, though, fantastic by Hennessy, and now it's Haugen. Haugen was looking to release Clark in front of her, but it's good defense again by McIntosh. They've done a lot better in this second half as they look to spring Annie O'Neill over the top. It's cleared out of bounds by Asia Selker, and it will be a throw in here for McIntosh on the far side.
And we're seeing that no-nonsense. Every single time that they think that the pace is getting a little too quick, you'll see the Lambert defenders just go ahead and knock it out of bounds and regroup.
They've learned their lesson, John. There's been a couple of times where they've been a little bit too composed on the ball, and McIntosh have pressed high. Now they're realizing they don't want to risk losing this shutout. They're still 24 minutes in. There's still time for the Chiefs to get back in this game.
Schulte once again letting Sydney Hennessy bring the ball back in center circle.
Good recovery there by Miner. Galbraith with her back to goal was able to release it wide. A nice spin there by McIntosh and tripped there. And it will be a free kick in a dangerous area for the Chiefs.
Looks like 25 or so. Let's see what McIntosh has in mind here.
I would say you don't want to shoot from this distance on an average day, but on a day like this, why not take a rip?
Wind it up and see what happens. So let's see how McIntosh is looking formationally. They're kind of lined up picket fence outside the 18 and into the 18 around the back post. So it looks like back post entry here.
It looks like Minor on this one. It's hard to tell with the numbers right now with the rain pummeling down. It will be a right-footed delivery here. It's straight. It's on frame. It's chipped around. And that one, a good save there. I believe she made contact. And no save given. That one just trickled far off the near post.
Looking for Galbraith there and went through Maddie Schulte's arms as she was trying to bend down and possibly parry it away. But neither Schulte nor Galbraith were there, and it ends up being goal kick for Lambert as we're coming up on 22 and a half to go.
A goal kick bounced a couple of times, but it's defended well again by McIntosh. Minor over the top, no-nonsense clearance by Hennessy. Clark with some good work there to lay it backwards, but again, out of bounds. It will be a Lambert throw-in just in front of us in the McIntosh half.
So now that we're coming up on the halfway point here in the second half, three-quarter pull, what have you seen so far?
I'm impressed with McIntosh. They've come out and they've pressed higher. It's definitely been successful, but they haven't created any golden opportunities as of yet. Lambert still stout in defense, and that ball by Hennessy was fantastic to the far side. But again, defended well by McIntosh. They're doing better to get numbers behind the ball, and they're not dawdling on the ball now. They're realizing that, you know what, when we take chances, we make mistakes. Let's just get clear.
Emerson Zimmerman once again going down the far side, and looks like next opportunity, which will be right now. Lainey Cassidy will be checking in, the freshman defender. Asia Selka will be checking out temporarily. Great work by Selka, number 11 for Lambert tonight.
It's a throw in for Lambert. The newly entering Lainey Cassidy will go all the way up to take it just behind the corner flag here. She throws that one into the 18-yard box, gets it back. First touch a little bit heavy, allowed Annie O'Neill to pounce for McIntosh. Another nice play by Idem, but Idem punished there. Deemed that her challenge on Megan Hong on the halfway line was a little bit too physical there. Hong having a word with the referee there.
Perhaps persistent infringement. Could there have been a card issued? Thoughts perhaps from Megan Hong as she sets it up.
Delivery deep towards the penalty spot. Goalkeeper just about handles that one. Ali Silber popped it up in the air, caught it at the second opportunity, and bowls it out fast to try and get attack started for the Chiefs.
Once again, Taylor Clark, a part of the conversation that we've had, the senior forward all day long, trying to get something done quickly, coming back offensively. McIntosh throw-in in the middle third as they're heading toward their offensive third.
Duvar with a great throw over the top, finding Miner on this near side. Miner's hard work earns a corner for McIntosh.
Miner going up against Riley Huffman that time. Huffman was the last to touch it, trying to stand up to make sure that nothing could come along the touch line. Take a big right-hand turn to drive toward net. So Huffman touches it last. Corner here, left-hand side on the near.
Morgan Yoakum trotted over to take this one. Looks like a training ground move as they check in. A shot from distance and a good big pour down to her right-hand side by Schulte. And that one was straight out of the training ground, John.
Grounder, no real arc to it. 45-degree angle right inside the 18, left boot. Schulte was there to parry it away. We'll try it again.
This time, McIntosh lineup all on the far post. There's a bunch of green. Plenty of white bodies, though, back to defend here. Referee having a quick look. It's played just underneath the goalkeeper. It's a big punch by Schulte. And that one always going in favor of the goalkeeper. She's down holding her knee.
Big collision there. She tried to punch clear with both fists.
Brave by Schulte in goal there. The senior that's committed to Emory. Good D3 school, Emory. But she is down hurt right now. That was the most dangerous phase of play we've seen from McIntosh during the game, though. Two good corner kick deliveries. But some concerns right now for Maddie Schulte in goal as the athletic trainer looks to whether they will be needed to offer treatment.
Scott Luthart coming out also for Lambert here to check on his keeper. What's it like, since you're the resident keeper here, what's it like going up against all of those bodies coming in and crashing against you and facing these corner kicks with all of this action going on?
It's definitely tough, and we will see a goalkeeper switch right now. Schulte will be out. Hannah Hubbard will come in, and potentially this is partially due to injury, partially due to wanting to get some minutes for your other goalkeeper during a game that's still 2-0 with 18:41 remaining. But John, back to your original question, it's tough. Particularly when you're a goalkeeper of Schulte's build, she's not the tallest. She isn't gifted with height. There's a lot of other players that are taller than you around, but you have to realize that you need to come and get your hands on it if you are going to come. And it's that decision making that can be really tough for a goalkeeper, but Schulte handled that expertly.
Swapping out one senior for another. You mentioned Hannah Hubbard coming in. So two senior keepers, obviously that's big for teams that want to make deep runs into the playoffs with the experience that's there between the sticks.
Definitely, and you want someone that isn't nervous, that's been there before, because it can be really tough for younger goalkeepers to step into some big shoes, and they've got players that may have up to 4 years of varsity experience under their belts as Lambert looked to break. That was the first poor touch we've seen from Madison Haugen in a while, and it will be a throw-in for McIntosh, which they take quick. A beautiful spin there by Annie O'Neill on the right-hand side. Looks to get it back from Miner. Miner double-teamed, though, and Lambert come out with it after that tough defensive play. They do turn it over, though, and it will be Galbraith. Galbraith turns, spins, takes a shot, skips up, parried by the goalkeeper, saved a second time, and somehow, John, it stays out the back of the net. That looked like a certain goal for the Chiefs.
First shot goes through the gloves of Hannah Hubbard. Had a chance to get a second, and it goes through the gloves, under the body, and over to the far post. So two big chances for McIntosh here with 17.5 to go, and it's still 2-0.
Good early signs for McIntosh, though, as they come away with the ball. Donaldson finds Miner. Miner looks for the reverse pass. Galbraith unable to chase that one. And to me, John, Galbraith looks like she's a step slower now. I think she must be exhausted after all that legwork.
All that legwork so far in the first 63 minutes or so. And you end up with Hannah Hubbard with it, and she brings it forward. So let's see who gets it this time. Middle third, good spin move there. Lambert's going to come out with it and try to send Taylor Clark, but it ends up on the back line for McIntosh for the big change.
Dangerous ball over the top by Zenis. Goalkeeper lets that one run, and she will be subbed out. So Hubbard did her job, kept it a shutout there. One decent save. We'll give her the second save, and back in goal will be Schulte after being cleared by the athletic trainer.
So on the sub, you're looking at just about 16 minutes to go here with a 2-0 lead for Lambert. Everybody, thanks for once again hanging out with us here on a rainy night for the Soccer Down Here SDH Network's Game of the Week.
McIntosh clearing the ball long from the defensive half. Miner popping that one up in the air and returning back to the game. Schulte, her first touch is similar to most of her touches during this game, a confident pickup on the edge of her 18-yard box. Punts it long, takes a skip. McIntosh do well to defend in the air, though.
It's going to stay in. Look at that.
Lambert eventually come up on the end of that. A weak pass, though, down the far touchline enables McIntosh to chip it over the top. Gorbryth flicks it on. Great run there by McIntosh, and it will be a free kick, I believe.
Just outside.
Just outside of the box as Emily Idem is chopped down central, probably 19 yards out there. It couldn't have got much closer to a penalty there if they'd tried.
Caitlin Olison was there trying to get the ball away from Idem, so let's see here where it's going to – they're going to say it happened a little further back, so top of the circle, and it looks like Morgan Yoakum is going to take for McIntosh. So you're probably looking 20 yards or so away, almost straight on. So here's another challenge for Maddie Schulte.
Tough conditions here. Will she opt to go high or low? Yoakum with a very straight run up here. Just smashes it, and a great save there by Schulte. The most important thing about that save was she didn't give a rebound, had four green jerseys bearing down at her, and Schulte with a strong catch there from the hard-drilled free kick.
Gloves up to make sure that all of that velocity behind it didn't get a big rebound. Just knocks it down to the ground after the initial punch and parry. Grabs it. Easy save.
And a foul call just shy of the halfway line in favor of Lambert. Chopped down there. And it will be Captain Sydney Hennessy stepping up to put her boot on this one. Her deliveries have been almost perfect during this match. Consistently long and far and dropping in a dangerous area that's hard to defend for McIntosh. This one a little easier, thighed up in the air by the McIntosh defender. And a free kick will be called in favor of the Chiefs.
High line that time for McIntosh at about 25 yards away. Forced Lambert to try to figure out what to do with far too much space to their liking between that and the net.
The long clearance by McIntosh simply headed back by Lambert. Lambert will look to build out of their defense. A dangerously under-hit pass, but Hennessy there. Huffman is challenged. Hennessy uses her body strength, and now she'll try and break over the halfway line. Hennessy with a nosebleed run there. She's in foreign territory. She does turn it over. Strong side-by-side challenge by Huffman. And now it will be Haugen. Haugen cutting inside towards the center of the pitch, lays it perfectly across, and a good shot, but an easy save there by Ali Silbert. Got her body behind it all the way and just skipped into her hands.
Emerson Zimmerman tried to turn with the left and put some power behind it, but there was a McIntosh body in between her and the net, so she really couldn't get a full turn and a full velocity behind it. So it was an easy pickup that time for Silbert to make sure that it was in both hands.
Miner drives across the halfway line, lays it into Gorbryth. Gorbryth can't spin on that one. And no prizes for guessing. Hennessy there again with her body behind the ball. It's been an exceptional performance by Sydney Hennessy, and you can see why UT wants her to play for them next season, John.
Asia Selka coming in for Lambert. And coming in, Marina Serra for McIntosh. Looks like Caitlin Castelli is going to take a break with just under 12 minutes to go as well.
And McIntosh know that time is starting to run out here. They need to get a goal in the next few minutes to really give themselves an opportunity to get something out of this match. Foul called again just outside the centre circle against McIntosh. Will be a free kick here, and Hennessy will step up to take it again. McIntosh still playing that dangerous high line, John. And I call it dangerous because in these conditions, all it takes is a skip pass.
I was going to ask you about that, yeah.
It's just so risky to me because the ball is bobbling. We've seen players flick on, and next thing you know, there'll be a Lambert player one-on-one at goal. Long and over the top. Confident play out the back, though, by the Chiefs. And now Annie O'Neill will break. Lays it in to Gulbert. Gulbert again unable to spin on the touch. And instead, Lambert have possession through Zimmerman on this right-hand side. Looks to switch the play. A great step out the back by Zenis. Annie O'Neill trying to get back to recover that one. Unable to save it. And it will be a throw-in 15 yards from the touchline for Lambert.
Once again chasing after Madison Haugen, who's getting a lot of play and a lot of freedom in the center of the pitch and over on her left-hand side. So as we come up to 10 minutes to go, Lambert with another opportunity and they're attacking third, but McIntosh defends it nicely.
Miss hit though by Sarah as they come away with it through Zimmerman. Lambert here, Zimmerman was looking for the return pass, puts in a tough challenge. It's cleared over the top, but easily met there by Megan Hong. Throw in for the Chiefs here.
Can they spring Galbraith here with under 10 minutes to go? Seeing a lot of Lambert bodies just kind of clogging the attacking lanes and clogging the middle third right now to make sure that McIntosh can't get any kind of momentum when it comes to attack to trim this two-goal deficit.
Throw in for Duval over the top. To Galbraith, tries to head it on. Megan Hong blocks the first one, and Hennessy is there to clean things up. A great step, though, by Duval for the Chiefs. Tries to lay it down the line, but instead it's blocked, and McIntosh will have to be okay with turning that one out for
not
a throw-in.
Not enough behind at that time with as you were looking for Duval trying to spring an attack with about 9 minutes to go.
I'm just so impressed, John, with defensively how Lambert are.
No doubt.
They are so organized back there, and they're not allowing McIntosh a whiff at goal here. Clark with a great spin. Looked to spread the ball wide. A little bit of an under hit there. Enabled Pickard to come out with that one and find O'Neill. O'Neill with a lovely 1-2 pass. Breaking forward over the halfway line with numbers is McIntosh. Laying it back to O'Neill. O'Neill tries to whip it across, finds Galbraith. Galbraith knocks it back to Minor. Minor takes a rip over the top.
Just over the bar.
And Schulte looked like she was confident that that one was going over potentially. Didn't try and jump for that one. Just stuck her hand up there and may have been caught off her line there. And I don't blame Minor for taking a rip when she noticed how far off her line Maddie Schulte was.
Caitlin Castelli checking in for Lambert. Taylor Clark will sit with about 8 minutes to go. But, yeah, that one looked like you had Maddie Schulte slightly off her line. It was one of those why not moments because you mentioned what it is in these conditions. You know, you take a shot and see what happens. But there was just enough where it would clear the crossbar, and we've got a race down to the other side.
Foot race here, but goalkeeper wins it. Ali Silbert pops that one up in the air. Was flicked on by O'Neill. And a foul again called against McIntosh in that center circle. Persistent fouling by the Chiefs right now, but they're doing it in smart areas. It's in areas where the referee isn't going to penalize them severely for. It's in that center circle.
Once again, we mentioned how Asia Selka has been a part of the attack and integral to what Lambert has been doing. Not necessarily showing up on score sheets, but really being one of those instigators that they've had offensively.
Yeah, it's all come from the high pressure as a swing and a miss by the McIntosh defender. Fortunately for them, Ali Silbert was there with the big catch. Punts it high and central. Attempted flick on by Simon. She gets it back again. Simon tries to spin, but fantastic pressure by Fontana.
Good chip idea there.
was looking to spread the play wide, Lambert, but overhit there. The ideas of their execution difficult in these conditions. It has stopped raining, but that slippy turf is not going anywhere as Galbraith turns and looks to thread through Kimmel, but Kimmel not quick enough there. Maddie Schulte again, her starting position has been fantastic.
Lambert looking to sub at the next opportunity. You'll have two more Longhorns coming in here as we come up under 6.5 to go regulation. The margin's still 2.
Spread wide. A good first touch there by Haugen. Haugen shoots, and that one always going wide there. No danger there from the shot, and it will be a goal kick, and we'll see those substitutions coming in.
Chloe Pendleton, the sophomore, getting some action here with about 6 minutes to go. And you'll also see Lindsay Webb, the freshman, coming in for Lambert. And you will see a couple of players check out. Looks like it's going to be Lainey Cassidy checking out, as well as Caitlin Olison for the Longhorns.
And at this point, John, you mentioned that Lambert has another game in just 2 days. You wonder if the coach is thinking about rotation and giving a little bit of rest.
Avery Mitchell checking in for McIntosh with the rush for the Chiefs here down into the attacking third.
Good spin by Sarah, and she spreads it wide to Simon. Simon on the far side right now, touchline, trying to break free. Well defended again, though. What can Simon do? She pins the defender in. All she does is give away a foul there. A little bit of frustration by Simon. It was a good run, but unable to get the delivery in.
Coming up on 5 minutes to go, so it's got to be a pedal down situation here for McIntosh, continuing to press as we've seen. But as you've mentioned here in the match, you press, you create opportunities going the other way. If there's a slip, if there's something that happens, any bit of misfortune that goes down because of conditions or because of overplay in general, then you could have something happen in return. Action here, middle third.
Heavy touch there by Lambert, but they do recover it. Playing down that left-hand far side. Skips over the McIntosh defender, and instead Lambert do come up with it. On this far side was Hong over the top, but it will be a McIntosh defender that's able to be first to the ball. Her pass finds Idem. Nice through ball, but read perfectly by the Lambert defensive line. Hennessy with the big switch over the top. Hennessy with some good vision, but just not on the same wavelength was Madison Haugen.
Yep, well over the top at the 4 minute mark. And having to track the ball down very, very quickly. A long run for Lauren Snell to try to reintroduce it, because time is ticking against McIntosh right now. It's the 12th defender right now is the clock.
I don't blame Lambert right now. I think they're going to try and get rid of it at any point, and any seconds they get off the clock through the McIntosh players chasing, they won't be complaining. And Lambert now cutting into the 18-yard box, drilled across just a little bit too far there behind the forward that was bombing into the box. But again, Lambert has had its most success on the wings, cutting back in as we see a couple of substitutions.
Olivia Miner checking in, number 27. Becca Lobel checking in. Lobel the sophomore, Miner the junior.
Throwing down the line, flicked on by Lobel. Miner trying to get onto it. It's good defense by Huffman. Miner attempts a long through ball, but it's easily defended. And instead, Fontana wins it. Her pass, though, read well by McIntosh, and they'll come away with it here in the center circle. Time is ticking on them. They will need to make a decision fast as they spread the play wide. First touch, not quite there, but get a second opportunity at it. Hennessy gets caught the wrong side, but things are cleaned up, and it will be a corner kick here for McIntosh with 2:30 on the clock. You have to wonder if they're going to push everyone forward.
Silbert looking to try to see if she's going to be a part of the equation here with 2:20 to go. Not at the moment, but there's a big crowd in the goal crease.
Everyone lined up on the touchline here. It will be an outswinging delivery as they move towards the penalty spot. Execution just not there, but it does bounce out as they play it back to the corner kick taker. Will they get a second opportunity? They do break through the first challenge, but just a couple of underhit passes here. And the foul called against McIntosh again, John.
Macy Simon called for the foul as she was trying to figure out where the ball was. It was underneath her as she was trying to both get her footing from a defender and get out from the same defender. So now we're at 100 seconds, 2-0.
No rushes expected by Sydney Hennessy. With that kick, clears it long over the top. Avery Mitchell with some good defense there to get the ball back to her goalkeeper. Mitchell receives it again, but just rushes that pass down the line a little bit, and it'll go out of bounds for a Lambert throw-in again, John. No rush here for Olesen as she takes this throw-in.
Two solid hands on it. Intercepted by McIntosh, launched into the middle third. But that tenacious defense that we've seen from the Longhorns all day has been a part of it. Big scramble now, and McIntosh trying to do it. Double team back into the middle third.
Absolutely. It's a brick wall back there defending for Lambert as McIntosh tried to restart things through Ali Silbert in goal. 49 seconds and ticking, time running out. Silbert under hits that one straight to the forward. It goes wide to Pendleton. Pendleton with the shot over the head. And that will be 3-0 there. Looked like Chloe Pendleton with the rip. She saw Ali Silbert off of her line. And that one just hit the top netting. We'll call it top bins there for that third goal for Lambert Girls Soccer.
So the goal at 39-21 of the second half, 79-21 overall, makes it 3-0. And we'll play out, obviously, the final 38 and a half seconds, but just tremendous work all game long by Lambert here, dominating performance on the road.
Fantastic, as McIntosh tried to create a chance from the kickoff. Goalkeeper Maddie Schulte will be there, as she's been there all game. You have to praise her in goal, as she should get the shutout today. She's made a couple of big saves, but it's her positioning that's made it so difficult for McIntosh to create any chances for themselves.
Coming up on 15 seconds. McIntosh trying to get one last opportunity here to launch. But a lot of the action here, middle third as we count it down. And a dominating win for Lambert on the road. 3-0 victors at McIntosh Stadium against the Chiefs. Jess, what'd you think?
I think Lambert were absolutely fantastic. I don't think McIntosh were bad. I think the formation killed them today. We mentioned how it seemed like Galbraith was so isolated in today's match, and I just don't think it went well for them. But Lambert must be praised. They are so well organized. The players have great discipline. And when you have defenders like Sydney Hennessy, when you have Megan Hong, when you have Selke working hard, Olesen, you could list so many Lambert players that just put in the legwork today, had the physical presence. And for me, McIntosh didn't stand a chance with the way that Lambert was so organized defensively. The 4-3-3 was a great choice by their coach.
And we talked once again with Casey Kreitner. You get a big win. You learn some things about how you are. You schedule very tough teams. Pace, Woodward, Pius, they're all going to be a part of the non-region schedule for McIntosh. But at the same time, you learn just as much about yourself in a close win and in a loss at home like you have today.
Definitely. They'll learn a lot from today's game. Firstly, they'll learn that they need to finish the chances they create. They had a couple of good opportunities where I think they rushed them a little bit. They didn't finish as well as they would have liked to. And I think they'll learn what it's like to take a loss. Sometimes you need to have that loss early on in the season because it's a bit of a wake-up call for you. They are the reigning champions in 5A. Potentially they had an easier schedule last year. So this year there's going to be big challenges in front of them, but that's a great thing for McIntosh. You need those tough challenges because that's when you find out what your team is really about and who deserves that starting spot on the pitch.
Expectations very high for both McIntosh and Lambert. Thanks for hanging out with us for the Soccer Down Here SDH Network Game of the Week. We'll be back at it again next Friday night, the 21st. It is Pope at Harrison in Cobb County, Greyhounds and Hoyas, and we'll be with you for both the boys and the girls matches from HHS. So, for Jessica Charman, I'm John Nelson. Reminder, Atlanta United's friendly against Leonis Negros, 9 o'clock, so in about an hour and a half if you're listening to us live, atlutd.com/live. Mike Conti, Jason Longshore will walk you through that one, and we will talk about that one tomorrow morning on Soccer Down Here. Actually, we'll talk about it to you tomorrow night on Soccer Down Here because the guys are going to be on a plane coming back from calling that particular match. So, 6 o'clock Eastern will be the live Soccer Down Here for Wednesday. So as Jason and Mike are on a plane, the normal time slot. It's going to be 6 to 8 p.m. Eastern. We'll talk about this. We'll talk about Leones Negros. We'll talk about Atlanta United. We'll talk about everything going on that is going on here in soccer in the South. So for Jessup, I'm John. Played safe, everybody. Thanks for hanging out with us for the SDH Network's Soccer Down Here Game of the Week. We'll see you next time.